Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. There are some special ethers in organic chemistry. One of them is the benzyl ether. In the upper right of the slide, the benzyl ether has a CH2 phenyl off the oxygen. This group is often abbreviated BN, uppercase B and lowercase N. How does one make this ether? The synthesis is shown across the top of the slide. We'll use a Williamson ether synthesis. This reaction is perfect for making benzyl ethers. The halide that we use over towards the right is either benzyl chloride or benzyl bromide. It's primary and lacks beta hydrogens. There is no risk of doing an E2 with the alkoxide. This is exclusively going to do an SN2. These reactions tend to be very clean and high yielding. What makes this ether so special? Is it resistant to acid? No, you can cleave a benzyl ether with acids like HBr very easily. What is special about the benzyl ether is that it can be cleaved with hydrogen and palladium-on-carbon, PDC. Let's say that this molecule in the bottom left is our starting material. It has two ethers. If we treat it with H2 and palladium-on-carbon, we'll only cleave the benzyl ether. The ethyl ether will not react. Note that the benzyl group forms toluene, methylbenzene as a side product. This reaction is called a hydrogenolysis because hydrogen is cleaving lysine, the CO bond. This is a really useful reaction. With the benzyl group, we have a type of ether that we can selectively cleave without affecting other ethers in the molecule. This ability to affect one example of a functional group without affecting other examples of the same functional group is very valuable for organic chemists. We'll see more of the benzyl ether as we get into protecting groups later in this playlist.